Hey everyone, it's me, Todd Howard. Hey, you know, we've had a really weird year, you know, what with making a bad game and getting sued and all, and, you know, even though we messed up the rollout of 76 and messed up the patching of 76 and pretty much just totally failed at releasing this new awesome game, would you guys mind just playing it again, please? In 2008, Phil Harrison, who at the time was Sony's head of development, said he thought the industry would shy away from single-player games, and that the industry would want more games with network connectivity. In 2010, Electronics Arts label president Frank Gibeau, I hope I'm saying that right, hilariously tried to play up EA's new business model that would be moving away from offline single-player games. Oh yeah. You guys have a great business model. You guys never had an insanely successful single-player game ever. And what do you know? After EA shit-canned Visceral Games, a Forbes article just couldn't help but declare the demise of solo-player games. And let's all not forget the devs of Payday saying single-player games aren't profitable all the way back in 2017. Even though Starbreeze, the studio behind Payday, made tons of money off of Overkill's The Walking Dead, Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons, and the Syndicate reboot. I mean, Brothers alone sold 800,000 copies before they sold it to 505 Games for $500,000 in 2015, because apparently $12 million in sales somehow doesn't translate to profit. But you're right, Starbreeze, there's no money at all to be made. 9 years. 9 years of grand wisdom from the executives of the gaming industry, and 9 years of being totally goddamn wrong. Let me just assure you all, the talk about the demise of linear titles has been greatly exaggerated. The industry simply tried really hard to strangle the single-player baby in its crib, and they failed so completely. 9 years after EA said what they said, they are hilariously enough releasing a single-player game. Alright everyone, we've arrived! Welcome back, single-player games! The irony is as hilarious to me as it is fascinating. Another blatant example of short-sightedness. That gamers didn't want single-player games, they wanted all that online connectivity. They wanted multiplayer and battle royale. Every game needs a multiplayer, no matter how strange it is. Remember Assassin's Creed Brotherhood? With its strange multiplayer that no one played? It was so popular and so necessary that later expansions of the Assassin's Creed universe didn't include multiplayer at all. How about Dead Space? Number 2 in the franchise had Team Deathmatch multiplayer. The third iteration, however, just got co-op. But the suits thought they knew better. They thought they knew what gamers really wanted deep down. Except when you realize they don't. And they never really have. And that's why it happened. That's the specific reason why the industry boldly prognosticated the demise of linear gaming, specifically focusing on the single-player horror game as the penultimate example of that failed linear experience. Around the time Dead Space was cooling off, a noticeable lack of horror games precipitated over the market. Except those games didn't really fail, did they? They were just shot in the back of the head by publishers. Horror games weren't as profitable as other genres because not everyone likes to be scared. I mean, they were still profitable, just not ultra super mega profitable. So of course this meant no studio wanted to spend resources making them. Real quick though, laugh with me, okay, at this screen grab of Gears of War creator Cliff Bleszinski saying there is no gainful benefit to horror games. You fucking idiots. What's most insulting about this whole anti-single-player divination scheme is that top industry executives seriously thought they could kill an entire market that they've been supplying products to for decades. The hilariously sophomoric idea that this could kill this. a completely asinine thought process that by simply uttering the words, they could kill a less profitable sector for one that was just starting. They put all their money-making hopes and dreams on this live service, less single-player idea that wasn't even fleshed out yet. And in those 9 years, since single-player games have been on the decline, where has the success been? Certainly not with the online massive multiplayer titles. Single-player games are, dare I say it, always going to be a staple of gaming culture. There are always going to be players who prefer time with themselves and no one else. When I come from my job and I come home, I don't want to play games with people. I want to get on Fallout and shoot a super mutant in the face. That's what I want. Even if the industry gets their way, alright, and is able to stop making solo titles, gamers will still find a market worth participating in. Or smaller indie studios that make games like Darkest Dungeon. Consumers were starving for solo experiences after the industry just up and decided no one wanted them. When the linear titles returned, they were gobbled up by the masses. Millions upon millions of dollars handed over for a type of game that EA and other tepid siloists guaranteed me were on the way out. I laugh nowadays because I constantly read articles from the likes of Kotaku and Game Informer announcing the triumphant return of the linear game. But they never went anywhere. The AAA industry just made less of them. Even while gaming publishers were talking about the demise of single-player games, Dead Space was still considered one of the best horror games of all time. And let's do our best to remember the critical success of Bioshock, Fallout 3, and Dishonored, and Uncharted, and Portal, and Mass Effect, and Dragon Age, and Skyrim, and Skyrim, and Skyrim, and so much goddamn Skyrim. Amazing. Linear games have always been present. They've always been around. This is even me ignoring the wonderful decade linear gaming has had on the indie market. Cause remember, Outlast was one of the best horror games ever made. Even today, traditional linear games like Octopath Traveler and Bravely Default continue to wow me with its fresh take on old mechanics. Especially when you take into account, okay, Square Enix, who is specifically known for making wonderful JRPGs, was shocked they made a good JRPG. We shouldn't kid ourselves here either. Those linear games made money and sold copies not because they were stunningly different, not because they were hyped beyond belief, it's because consumers wanted them. I will never understand why the industry is so averse to single-player content when it's been shown time and time again to be a win for the industry. But why do that when you could just chase the market leader in a sad attempt to duplicate its success? The industry as a whole is so creatively delayed that it's easier for them to just try and erase a whole genre and make the same old dirty military shooter everyone else is making. Why try innovating when you could just make the same thing till infinity and charge crap tons of money for useless shit so every deep-pocketed jackass can keep your rickety tower of papier-mâché and sticks afloat?
Extreme sarcasm!
While every publisher tries to fit their avaricious hands in the same goddamn cookie jar. That's not even how you business write. That's not even how business works. You are far more likely to remain profitable and solvent much longer if you appeal to more people. If Fortnite is successful and another publisher makes a Fortnite clone, that doesn't mean you are going to get Fortnite levels of cash or Fortnite levels of prosperity. You don't ignore niche markets. You find the ones that are underfunded and you provide a service to that customer base. Focusing on a long-term business strategy is far more stable than relying on hype culture. You can even still have your big live service games on tap as well. It's not like it has to be one or the other. You can have long-running live service games while you make an awesome single-player game. The industry always acts like it has to pick and choose between long-running cash services and solo title art pieces, but they don't. They can literally have a flagship money machine while they provide content to the content starved. It's not a matter of profitability, because the profit is there. It's not a matter of player base either, because players want those types of games. It's just laziness. It's nothing more than laziness and bad management. The AAA market could be far more stable would they just be able to find that happy medium. But instead, they deal with job insecurity, mass amounts of stress, and layoffs. Way to go, AAA companies. Way to go.